In Vision Group's Green Schools debate that has seen schools from across the regions battle it out, Chebambe Girls School won in the Mid-Central chapter.
Green schools, we love nature, we treasure nature, and we fight for nature.
We are so happy to win because we've seen it's worth it, our energy that we've invested in. We practice, though there are some downfalls. But I'm so happy that you've made
it. Because we believe young minds are still impressionable. Once they have bought into something, then sustainability is guaranteed. We have a brighter future.
I want to request you to be ambassadors of change. Go and plant a tree just after having avocado. Do something with that seed.
Meanwhile, UNHCR staff in Mbarara today spent the day collecting plastics. The initiative was part of their activities to mark the International Refugee Day, which was celebrated yesterday.
As OPM and UNHCR, we thought of activities for this day, and one of them was to collect plastics along River Ruizi.
We, as UNHCR, we are always protecting our environment in our projects. In all what we are doing in the settlement, we always take into consideration the environment.
The team also planted trees along River Ruizi banks.
River Ruizi, incidentally, is the only source we have here in Mbarara, but it even stretches up to Isinjiro, where you are having the refugees. So it is an important activity of ensuring that we protect River Ruizi.
In Fort Portal, a 9-month-old baby needs 70 million shillings to treat a heart condition. Baby Monica Nyangoma is a daughter to Bataringaya Tadeo and Kebirunji Annette of Chisomoro sub-county in Bunyangabo district. At Mulago Heart Institute, scans indicated that the baby's heart has two holes which require an operation to clear the condition. The parents were advised to take the baby to India for treatment. In Mitiana town, residents jubilated upon learning about the recovery of a 5-year-old child who had been missing for 1 week. One arrest has been made in the matter. Emmanuel Kaima, who is the son of Godfrey Sechanzi, a prominent trader in Masaka town, went missing last week as he returned from school. Today morning, one of the residents found the child abandoned in an old house.
This boy was found abandoned in a house, unfinished house in Buyechi Kumbi, about 200 meters from his school. We have taken him to Mitiana Hospital for medical examination as efforts to have the suspects involved arrested continue.
Meanwhile, in Mubende, police recovered a baby who had been stolen from her parents in Katogo village. Report by Luke Kajiri, Jonan Tufsingwire, Abdul Karim Sengendo, Rogers Akanyi Juka, and Jonathan Mitala for the news.